David Seymour is pushing back against claims the ACT Party's Treaty Principles Bill is creating division. Dozens of supporters attended his State of the Nation speech in Auckland today, where the party promised to deliver real change to all New Zealanders, Isabel Prasad reports.
While the scones were a hit, it was an appetite for change, drawing in the ACT Party faithful today.
I'm very excited to hear that there is a real change coming for the country.
We face a time when there's increasing division.
The one that springs to mind is probably crime. The safety in our houses, the safety in our businesses.
David Seymour addressing their concerns in his State of the Nation speech.
New Zealanders are ready for change, and if we don't take care of their concerns, then someone else will.
But it's the party's Treaty Principles Bill that remains front and centre.
We believe we can persuade New Zealand that this is a good idea that will unite New Zealand.
The bill has been taking over political discussion, the Prime Minister saying his party doesn't intend to support it past its first reading.
We're making it possible, and if people want it to continue, then I suspect that our coalition partners might decide they do too.
Christopher Luxon in recent days handing over responsibility for the bill to David Seymour as Associate Justice Minister.
I think it just makes a lot of sense that the person who is driving the idea can talk to the government officials and make sure it's done right.
It sends a message to Māori that Christopher Luxon is not going to listen to Māori. He is okay with his ministers attacking Māori.
Despite widespread protest action and the Kingitanga's unity hui, ACT says it has no intention of backing down.
If we say that the treaty principles debate is divisive, what we're really saying is we can't do anything where people disagree in this country.
It was very, very clear he wants Te Tiriti o Waitangi rewritten. And any consideration of Māori having any say in anything in this country, gone.
The issue's likely to be a focal point at Waitangi celebrations.
Remembering that it is a marae and you always respect your manuhiri. But we're also very clear with our manuhiri. If you have caused offence, you must expect to be told so.
Based on the comments that some people have made, it will be more tense than other years.
Tension with no release in sight.
And Isabel joins us now. Kia ora, Isabel. Along with addressing hot topics here, Seymour also talked about the international scene. What did he have to say about that?
Kia ora, Wendy. That's right. David Seymour spent a decent amount of time today in his speech discussing the current international climate and the effects it is and could have here in New Zealand. He spoke of our closest allies ramping up defence efforts and also touched on the situation in the Red Sea, backing that decision to deploy New Zealand Defence Force personnel. Now, he said New Zealand's backyard was becoming a contested space, so it was important that the government made bold and brave decisions in what he described as a dangerous world. Mr. Seymour also used the United States and the election in the United States as an example of the importance of democracy, saying a divided US posed issues for all countries, especially New Zealand, Wendy.
Tēnā koe, thanks, Isabel.